We all know now the importance of showing girls that they're powerful, that they can write their own stories, that they can be heroes. But with this book, I saw the chance to introduce children to a living heroine they probably hadn't heard about yet, through a fantasy story that I knew would excite and inspire them.
Interestingly, a lot of editors wanted us to write a nonfiction account of Loujain, a biography, yet we didn't want to do that for a few reasons. The primary one being that anything that we put out at that time publicly could put Loujain and her family at risk. And we also wanted a story that was magical, a story with limitless possibilities, something like a dreamscape, because fantasy is such a powerful way to inspire kids. And for many kids of color, this dreamscape isn't visibly represented in a way that's accessible to them. And for kids generally, it's vitally important that they see that their heroes are as diverse as we know they are, and for other kids to also see that as well.
Fantasy is an excellent way to help children process reality, to teach them about things in their own world that may be harsh or difficult to face head on. So once we had this beautifully written fantasy story that showed a heroine who fought for change, who fought for equality, who fought for justice, we also wanted to make sure that this book as a picture book was visually right, right? Of course, we all know a picture book is very much about the interplay between the words and the images. We wanted to make sure that it was going to show beautiful brown children living in a magical world that children would want to climb right into and fly with Loujain and her Baba.
So honestly, this picture book was intimidating when I first got it, because Loujain is so inspiring and powerful. So I think if this book would have come to me from an art director that I didn't know and I wasn't familiar with, I think I would have been intimidated to take it on. But this story came to me from Uma, actually. And we are good friends and have known each other over a decade. And so I knew, given the fact that like, I don't share the same background as Loujain, you know, I've never been to Saudi Arabia. I don't have the same challenges that her family faces. But I knew that if Uma trusted me with that, then I wasn't going to take that lightly. I have a huge amount of respect for her. So the fact that she came to me with this story meant a lot. So when we met, I was a little bit familiar with Loujain's story, but not in depth. And then when I talked to Uma about it, I was just so moved and inspired. And reading this story and seeing the magic in it and learning more about Lina and their family and how they were fighting, I just felt like it was a challenge I was very honored to try and tackle. I mean, I watched documentaries and looked at photographs of Saudi Arabia, watched films, and I wanted it to feel that earthy color palette. So it was finding a way to like blend those bright tones in with that sort of like natural earthy tone. And that is one of the reasons I put the black pencil in there. It's just to kind of make it feel kind of classic and bold and kind of still have that earthiness, right? Where it's not like a rainbow. Until she hits that moment that when she flies, and then the shapes get very round and organic, and we've got these pinks and purples.